What is the poetry of Braddock?
Ode 71.
Hi. Poetry of Braddock.
What's the poetry of Braddock?
The where?
The poetry. The poetry of Braddock.
Of Braddock?
Yeah.
Wow. What a question, Anthony. The poetry of Braddock.
I'm a New Yorker. And I was driving this morning from the bridge straight out Braddock to East Junior High School. And just thinking, there is a strange beauty to this place. I didn't even know where I was. Driving along past all the ravines and the hillsides and the old mill works. And I was just thinking that if I were a poet, I'd be writing a poem about this.
Do you know any poems?
Poems?
Poems.
Do you know any poems?
No, I don't.
They're poems, man. I'm just a fish cleaner and a chicken chopper, Teddy.
Rain, snow, sleet, or hail, you can't stop the U.S. mail.
Roses are red, violets are blue.
Braddock is nice and I am too.
Roses are red, violets are blue.
I lived in Braddock, and so did you.
What Braddock makes, the world takes. That was our poetry at one time.
What does that mean?
What's it mean? Yeah. We made everything in Braddock at one time.
In many ways, Braddock was a utopia for me. I saw beauty there that was comparable to Camelot. And with that as a segue, I will say, each evening from December to December, before you go to sleep upon your cot, think back on all the tales that you remember of Braddock. Ask every person if he's heard the story. Tell it strong and clear if he has not. That once there was a shining piece of glory called Braddock. Amen. Where once it never rained till after sundown. By 8 a.m. the morning fog had flown. Don't let it be forgot that once there was a spot that for one brief shining moment known as Braddock.
Yeah, I'll tell you what's the poetry of Braddock. All good people come from Braddock. All good people.
So we come one and all to this quiet place where the breeze softly waves at the butterfly's grace. But where are the zealots who sound so loud when they rush us to war with righteousness and ambitious so proud? And where are the champions of preemption? Do they not come?
Poetry of Braddock for me is that it is a
part of my childhood that makes me come back here every year, and part of the tradition that my mother, so I can spend some time with my mother, and it taught me the tradition of family, being able to walk on the street and meet and greet your neighbor.
Braddock Avenue. They'll never come back. Two furniture stores, three banks, three movie houses, Capitol, Times, and Paramount. Where at 13 I let a strange boy put his hand on my knee, then confessed it to old Father Joe at St. Mary's on 6th Street. And where at 21 a ring was slipped on my finger while we watched on the town in the dark. I loved to shop the day before Christmas at Shubb's for fresh roasted peanuts, the smell catching you before you even got in the door. I love to stop at Oak's Delicatessen for corned beef, meals for
search me, Lord. Turn your light, turn your light from ahead. On my soul.
Oh. Well, if you find
anything that should not be me, please think it up and yes, learn me.
Lord, I wanna be right.
I want to be right.
And I wanna be made.
I want to be.
Let me say it again. Please search me.
Search me, Lord.
Y'all ought to come on and sing with me. Come on!
Please search me, Lord.
Yeah, turn your light.
Turn your lights from heaven.
Braddock Avenue reborn. Weeds and wild grasses have taken over lots where abandoned buildings were torn down. Near the Monongahela, deers graze. Turtles, ducks, rabbits and raccoons flourish where barges once unloaded coal and iron ore. It's not a new story. Sand covered the body of the Sphinx, only its head emerging to tantalize travelers.
But the thing is, no matter what we have and what we lose, I think the poetry of Braddock is, it's about the people.
Get on the avenue and talk to one another.
If I was to
describe the poetry of Braddock, I would say that it's definitely the youth, and it's definitely the seniors coming together to do positive things.
Poetry of Braddock is about working together. People from all walks of life working together. That's what it is.
The beauty of the people. The poetry of Braddock is in the people. It's in the flavor. It's in the people. It's in the neighborhoods. It's in the streets. It's, you know that.
I wrote this one myself.
Okay, good.
Today, I say, I guess it's okay, but tomorrow's a sorrow, and yesterday was gay. Never is forever, and the past at last has had a last laugh, but today, I say, is okay.